team or most of the filters are related with the match that is going on. They apply stickers, filters, and then upload and then share it with their friends. And recently, we started doing the voting thing. So for Bigg Boss Tamil and Telugu, the entire voting was powered by Hotstar, by the Hotstar app. This entire voting system was also used Kafka in the backend. So in a single day, there were 50 million votes submitted. Sorry. Now, why were we doing all these kind of things? We wanted to engage our user so as to create a social cricket watching experience or a social sports watching experience. So we wanted users to invite their friends and family to watch on WhatsApp. Why we wanted to do so? So that as to create a sports bar-like experience. So think of it, a sports bar-like vision. These are the real-time indicators that tell you about what your friends are doing. It can be as simple as that, hey, your friend is also watching the same video, or it can be like he won some reward playing the watch and play game. And so this was something that was done on the real-time basis. And when a scale, when 25 million people are doing, and everyone having at least around hundreds of friends today, so you have to notify all those people that what his friend is doing. So there's one example over the screen. This is like your friend has joined or he's waving at you. You can reply back. Now a user knows what my friend is doing, and or he is inviting me to the same video. So now Shubhajit is going to walk us through what challenges and what we faced while designing the social signal and how did we overcome those, and will walk us through.
Just to give you an idea, we have a user base of 300 million active users, and to handle that scale, that's a universal problem for all of the teams in Hotstar or the social, right? So second challenge is finding these friends of users online. Because if we don't find the friends, we can't notify them, right? Just to give you another idea how many friends people are having, we have a 22 billion node Amazon Neptune cluster that holds all these friends and the users. So it is that big, and it is in that hashtag that we have to find the friends. Thirdly, the third challenge was we found the friends. Now we have to connect them somehow, right? Just like we have to connect them saying that your friend is doing this, or your friend chatted, or your friend came online, you can now start chatting or play a game with them, right? So this indicator that we need to send, or this connect that we need to send out over the wire, that was the third challenge. And the fourth challenge is not to bombard the user with so many such notifications. Because suppose I'm watching and suppose it's last 2 hours, and like India needs like ball, over they need 12 runs and Dhoni is playing. So it's a crucial moment, right? So at that moment, all of the people, they will be tuned into Hotstar. They'll come at the same time. So if I am watching, 50 of my other friends will also be coming on the platform. And since that a crucial moment, I don't want to disturb the user saying that, okay, 50, so one friend came, then again one friend came. So I don't want to bombard the user with such notifications, right? The experience would be seamless for the user. So this also we have to keep in mind. Okay, so how did we solve all these challenges? Firstly, we used Kafka. So Kafka helped us in multiple places where so many events we were getting, right? On a daily basis, and during the match times the searches go crazy, right? So in a moment of like 5 seconds we'll get a search of 10 million people, and all of those start video events that we get, we need to somehow store it somewhere as a buffer, right? Because our systems won't scale that fast. Even we have a lot of thought put into the auto scaling groups that we have, still it doesn't scale so fast, right? So we had to put some kind of a buffer in between us and the incoming events. Otherwise, the backend system will start failing. They'll be calling the other dependent systems, and it'll be a whole circuit break happening. So we have to protect that somehow. So Kafka acted as a buffer between us and the world. So all of the incoming events, it could just absorb it, and our systems could read from Kafka at their own pace. If the consumer lag increased, we increase the system slowly. So that scaling happened in the background. So there was a bit of latency to the user, but that was like negligible. Like it was not, like if I get an indicator even after 30 seconds of my friend joining, that was fine for us. But we could easily catch up by slowly scaling up. If we didn't do that, then our system will eventually fail and that will be a blackout. So we didn't want that. So Kafka helped us there. Second challenge was to find these friends that I'm continuously talking about, right? So we used Amazon Neptune over there, and that also helped us beautifully. The response times to find first level friends of a user, it was very good. So the first level traversals were very easy, and the response times were under 10 milliseconds. So that service also helped us a lot. And thirdly, we were using Spark for this real-time data processing. So Spark has a streaming API that is called structured streaming, where you can read from different sources, Kafka being our source here, and there's a seamless integration with Kafka and Spark. So these streams of data were read into Spark, and we could do multiple joins with other data streams or other databases and enrich this data. So to give you an example, we are getting the start video event, but it only has a PID and nothing else, right? So we have to make some sense out of that event, saying that who are its friends and what is the event, what is he watching. We can't just say your friend is watching this content ID. That content ID doesn't make sense for that user, right? So they need to be shown like your friend is watching this match. So we have to enrich the data somehow. So we used Spark over there. Okay, so coming back to why Kafka, right? So as I said, Kafka acted as a buffer for the incoming events. So just to give you some numbers, we had like 1 million RPS at one point of time, 1 million RPS of ingestion rate into Kafka during the IPL match. So there Kafka acted as a buffer. It is highly resilient, highly scalable, highly performant. So our data team is actually the maintainer inside Hotstar for the Kafka clusters. They have done a great job in maintaining that. They have a 99.979% uptime for the Kafka clusters. And as I said, it acted as a surge protection. So whenever the surge came, we didn't have to handle it. Kafka did it for us. Okay. Then Kafka actually maintained the incoming events in a chronological manner, right? And that was a bit of an important thing for us, because for few use cases, not for all. So it became important for us because suppose for watch and play, where users are giving answers and we are giving scores to those answers and giving them rewards, and those rewards can be like cards. So like last IPL we were giving away cards to the match winners, right? So there will be some spoofing, there will be some hacking, right? So Kafka helped us there as well, where the incoming answers were put into one partition of Kafka, and all of the users, one user's answer went to one partition, and since it is chronological, we could just discard all of the answers that came after the first answer. So there also Kafka helped us. And in case of the failures, we could just replay the Kafka messages in the backend offline after the match probably, and then recollect the user scores, give out the rewards if they're pending. Also, if we could restart fix our services, it would just restart from the point where it left off. So Kafka